have time for, but I'm going to do it quick. This one is about alpha personalities and why I'm scared of almost, or all of society makes me nervous, almost all of it. And here's the deal with it. We have been sold that you should shoot to be alpha. It starts with shoes, and then it goes to more clothing, and then it goes to cars, and then it goes to, you know, and then it shoots off into sports. It's very important to project alpha. And I'm going to title this one, I should have started with this, I Married the Right Woman. I kind of lucked out over time, because my wife, we both laugh at things that most people get offended by. Things that people find super offensive, we just can't help but laugh. I mean, it's just like the world is preposterous. Also, the idea of alpha we see as equals empty. There's just not much to it. And we see it everywhere, and we both agree that it's kind of a world gone mad that way. And most people we bump into by the end. But here's an interesting twist. I have a friend that said, I think he's right. He said, I think people's first impression of you is alpha. And I think it's true. This has been true since I was in high school. When people first meet me, their first impression is alpha male. It's the tone of my voice, kind of I'm loud, sort of I'm out there. And people see that. And sometimes it's gotten me into trouble because right away people assume, there's a big assumption, which I'm making all the time, you know, that people are. But so many people are, but it's put me into pickles, what this friend was saying, that it's put me into pickles because it gets me there. And so I so lucked out not marrying one of my first sweethearts, and that I it's one of the reasons for my faith, is that I ended up with this person. We both kind of look at the world with this humorous lens of, could it be any more off? I mean, could it be any more off? And I think we both understand we're not into the romantic myth. We are into that work equals love, and that laziness equals the opposite of love, and that includes in the relationship. And this romantic myth, which dominates society, just is like it runs amok. And the romantic myth really believes that we should be trying to project an alpha type of personality. And my response is, especially to my evangelical friends and family, there already is an alpha. That role's been filled. You don't have to do that. But we all are trying to. We've all been sold it through television and media, and it's very important. I'm going to be number one. I'm going to be out front. I'm going to project myself as I really got it going on. And right away, that's why people say, why are you afraid of 95% of the people, or not afraid, maybe just made nervous by 95% of the people? Because we've all drank the Kool-Aid. And it's weird when it shows up. You'll be with people, and here's my thing. I'll be with people that I'm convinced are not alpha. And then at the weirdest moments, it's like, no, they are trying to project this alpha. I got the corner on this. And when people are really strong with that attitude, I gotta say, run for the hills. I mean, just get out of there. Like, if someone's telling you they know, they got the corner on the truth, these people have things in their closet that would make paint come off of walls. That's their way of protecting that. But I'm just gonna come out as strong as ever to hide away all the unspeakables in my life. And they're very good at it. Because for a while you're like, oh yeah, this person knows. Well, I don't think they do. But that's why. And that's why I married the perfect woman. We laugh at things that other people are offended by because we just see the world as kind of a crazy place. And we see that alpha personality is something that's shallow, weak, empty, and a big phony front for romantic mythicism versus real love, like genuine love. Have a good day. Lift people up.